the other way around.
It was just what the GRC leader needed after yesterday's wigging from the Lawlords. A complete change of gear in every sense.
I feel I could give a ruling about fares while I'm like this.
Way back in July, Ken Livingstone had accepted the invitation to be Santa for a day at the Toss Hill estate where he used to live, though few residents could remember him ever looking quite like this. The party was given by the 1 o'clock club, and mums and their children get together every day. Mr. Livingstone, a former councillor for the area, had helped raise £250,000 to build the Jubilee Community Centre, where today's jamboree was taking place. But even there, amidst the jellies, cakes, crisps and sandwiches, it was obvious that Santa still had yesterday on his mind.
What's your name? Tanya, what do you want for Christmas? Tell me cheap fares.
After an hour or so, in scarlet robes, smothered in children and occasionally their parents, Santa decided he had to get some fresh air, well aware that, just like Cinderella, he'd soon have to change roles and go back to the job of trying to save his fair's fair.
Well, we're going to start. The front page of the Londoner that goes out in January will be completely devoted to demanding that the fair scheme be saved. There'll be calling meetings in constituencies around London to actually build up support. We'll be asking all Londoners to write to their MP, petitions and so on, and building up to some sort of demonstration at the House of Commons.
An hour to go, it was back to the children, most of whom were far more interested in eating than accepting Santa's special offer.
Ho, 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 I'm giving away Lord Denning for Christmas. Anyone want Lord Denning as a Christmas present?
No!
Hooray!
Oddly enough, not one child asked for a train set. Tricia Ingram's in Tulsa for Thames News.